this first bit up here, what I just rotated. I had and dug it out before the winter. No manure. I might have limed it though. This bit up here had a lot of green manure. So this morning I've strimmed it up with my strimmer, which is over here. Then I used the Mantis tiller to chop it up a bit more and dig it into the soil a little bit. And then, as you've seen, got the other rotavator borrowed from my friend Bob, who's just over the other side of the allotment, and rotavated all the way down, as you've seen. This is the plot, February 2016. Just take a look in the polytunnel, bit of a mess. Oh, sitting down in the polytunnel now. That's it for today. Just trying to get my breath back. This is February 2016. And it's not a bad day at the moment. It's 21.5 degrees in the polytunnel here. Oh, I bought a couple of these little mini greenhouses. Thought I'd put them in the polytunnel. Right, this is where I'm thinking of putting it. Now I'm potting on some onion seed. Right, when it comes to watering seedlings, I like to use one of these sprayers. This one's probably a bit too big, but it's the one I got. It's got 1 tablespoon. Bicarbonate of soda in there. So you're asking yourself, why have you got that in there? Bicarbonate of soda helps to protect against fungi, and in this case, damping off. Anyway, these are also going in the that's our shelving I just made up. What's it called? 4-tier greenhouse. Right, this is the first real sowing of in the polytunnel this year. I've got other stuff growing, but it's the first sowing this year. There's going to be some carrots. Amsterdam forcing, if you can see that. Right, I'm going to sow some cabbage. It's B, F1, you see that? And some kale, Cavolo Nero, Nero di Toscana, I think it's called. I think I spelled that right, or pronounced it right. See that? Right, gonna sow some of Dan's favourites. Shallot Zibroon. Can you see that? I think I'll leave them down here tonight. There's no more. Got the labels. That's it, I think. March 7th, 2016. Gonna sow some lettuce, little gem. So you can see how I get on bare this time. I intend to transplant these on a bit anyway. Oh, that's better, isn't it? I think we'll call that a day now. Put these seeds back. I've also been marking the date on the packet and I've sowed it as well. So, cheerio from me. See you next time. Bye. Oh, I got a new lodger today. He's moved into the shed. Can you see him? It's Dave, the beer can man, all the way from Newcastle. Say hello. got some fish bone, give them a bit of feed. Went back with the new horse manure. Well, let's try to tidy it up a bit. And this. And I put a bird box up the other day, but I got to get a metal plate. I think I got one at home to put around the hole, to make it a bit smaller. Got a little bit of a bonfire going. If I fall off, let me know. This is the plate I got. I've had it a few years actually. Blue tit universal next box cover. I've drilled some holes in the bottom of here. The person who made it didn't do that, and I've also drilled a few across there as well. You see the holes on the bottom? I got some underneath as well. That's just to let the water drain out. What I've also done, I've got it in a bit of an angle. Can you see that? It's angled away from the shed. And that's so the water runs towards the front. But hopefully this won't get too much because it's under the lip of the roof of the shed there. I've acquired another one of these. I think they're called Jallo wheel hose. Although I don't think mine's got Jallo written on it. I think my little gem lettuce, which I sowed the other day, I think they might just be starting to show, but maybe not. You wouldn't be able to see it, I don't think, anyway. It's only a little tiny speck. This is sweet peas I sowed. And again, these are leeks I sowed a few months ago. They're all coming up now. So you can see that. So sweet seeded sweet peas. Doing wonderfully. And there's my grape in the corner. I show you the temperature in the polytunnel today. Totally different to yesterday. I think that's inside. Outside is 28 and 46% humidity. And a bit more of a tidy up around this area. Hopefully these raspberries are summer fruit in. There's my rhubarb. And there it is, it's all growing. These rhubarb here are grown from seed by my cousin in Cornwall.
These days, a lot of allotment sites are under threat.
This is a giant one. Giant wheelbarrow.
A couple of times, and then they just come. Just like you're compressing them, they come out. Nice little blocks, and they've got an indentation with your seed. So to be able to pot on, you need to make a square indentation like that. And take that little block, then once it's got, and it fits in.
This morning you were talking about covering raspberries and fruits. Any preference to colour?
I just use normal, just, you know, normal.
good, like fresh.
I haven't
used black.
No, but just normal.
Yeah. I'm just going to sew some board bins today. Just using these toilet rolls and kitchen rolls. And stopped off at a gardening shop on the way back from the edible garden show. Pick these up. Broad bean Sutton, they're a little dwarf one. £2.15 for a pack of those. I don't know how they're treated. You see that light dusty stuff on them? You can see they're doing really well. This is a hot cayenne pepper. I bought as plug plants. I picked up these blueberry plants from the edible garden show. Gonna plant some no-named shallots. Got them from Evesham up in the Midlands.
Just pinching the tops of these sweet peas out.
And these are the self-seeded ones. And they've done it all on their own. These are the red onion sets I planted the other day. This is the kale that I sowed on the 7th. And at the back is the cabbage. Friday, the 18th of March, 2016. Yeah, I got the date right today. Now I'm going to sow some beetroot today. Another packet from the Evesham store that we stopped off at. £2.05. Bolt beetroot, bolt hardy. Brussels sprouts, breast, if one. Brussels sprouts, green marble, if one. Some purple sprouting broccoli. Early purple, and some broccoli, calabrese, Samson F1. I'll pop a cover over them. Finish the digging of that bit anyway. Started to fill me bean trench in. Got some sweet williams here that we grew last year. Finally finished off doing the apple tree, pruning the apple tree. I think I can hear the kettle boiling. It's quite warm in the tunnel today. 25.1. This is my onion set. What do you think about that one? Do you think that's grubbing? Let's lift the pot up. Look at that. It's definitely growing. Last of the digging done, put my bean frame back up. Oh, what's that noise? Oh, bacon butties again. Right, I'm gonna start off my spuds in buckets. Nice little shoot. You see that? By the handles. And I'll give it a bit of water. These are just those laminate things. I print out the names, cut them off, put them on an A4 laminate. That'll sort of give you an idea of those. This is onions. Drop them between the laminate and then cut round them when you want them. You can write on these labels. Tuesday the 29th of March 2016. Update on the beetroot bolt hardy that we sowed on the 19th of the 3rd, 2016. As you can see,
I'm starting to
grow beans. The Saturn.
There's one coming through.
Just there. Now we got the broccoli, early purple, green marble, banana shallots. They're doing good. My seed sown onions, little gem lettuce. That's some cabbage that a plot neighbour gave me. The Nero, kale, the Calabrese. So everything's coming along quite well. Over in that bucket is some garlic. I'll swing you round. There's a nice puddle. God, we had some rain this morning. There's another puddle. The cauliflower is all year round that somebody gave me. We've taken the tops out of them, make them bush out. Stronger plants. Yellow shallots that I put into pots on the 17th of March. They don't seem to be doing much at the moment. Oh, there's a root. Oh, that was lucky. You see that? Shaking a bit here.
In the spud bucket yet, but I wasn't expecting anything.
Grape is starting to bud, I think. Rhubarb's gone down a bit. We took a cutting of it. I put half my bean sticks up. Water putts behind the new shed are now filled up. And actually coming out the overflow. Which I hope are summer fruiting. Now that's the update for Tuesday the 29th of March 2016. Don't think there's much else to show you. Temperature in here today at the moment is 23.7. That's in the Tolly Tunnel. Quite nice and warm really. So until next time, happy growing. Bye. Gonna repot some these Primo cabbage. Just some multi-purpose compost. Tease them out from each other. Hold them by the seed leaves. Pop them in the pot. Right, that's them done. I sowed a few other things the other day. Peppers. I think that's what that is there. Beauty Bell, F1. And early butternut squash. California Wonder pepper, cucumber, thin spot, munchkin pumpkin munchkin, and sweet million tomatoes. Sown down a polytunnel and brought it to the house for now. Also got some chilies. I just bought some plug plants. And Mrs. Plate has been also been sowing some flowers. This one is Cosmos. Seashells mixed. And this one. Is Dahlia Dwarf Double. Dahlia Dwarf Double. So they're taking up the whole tray, the two varieties. You can see they're all coming up. Shouldn't have sowed them the other day. Wednesday the 6th of April, potatoes are starting to come through. That's a charlotte I planted.
I'm going to put the rest of my potatoes in today. I'm only doing 6 buckets, with 4 potatoes in each bucket. Put 2 in this one, two peas have already got 2 in, you've just seen. So I'll put a couple more in here. Jason's opposite the handles this time. I went along with it last time. I'll leave a bit of space for watering. yard is partly watered. So that's 6 buckets of charlottes done now. 4 potatoes, 4 potatoes in each bucket, and a variety of fertilisers. I don't know if you can hear, it's actually raining. Can you hear that? It was bucketing down just a minute ago. That's one good thing about a polytunnel. You can be up here when it's bucketing down. Just sowed some carrots. 6th of April 2016. This tub is Autumn King. Sweet candle. 6th of April 2016. Onion bunching onions. I don't think I've ever grown these. No idea what these onions are, so I'm going to actually put some in all these wells. I'll fill all these up. Then we'll go from there. I'll do an ad and see how I get on. I'll show you what they're like actually. Speed it up. Cut out. Right, I'm going to sow some sweet corn today. You see that? Swift. But what we always do, we chit it, so I'm going to show you how to do that. Right, get your tub for tub, give it a water. That's what sweet corn seed looks like. Right, we're just going to put these in here, try and space them out a little bit. We've been doing this for decades. Just space them out a little bit. There you go. What's that? Can you see that? Right, get another bit of tissue and cover it up. Push it down a bit. Get some contact with the seed and a bit more water. Keep it watered. And that's it. Nice quadrace down. I'll put that in there for the label. Just thought I'd show you a couple of chili plants overwintered by cutting down a bit, because what you want is the light shoots coming from the bottom, and then you can see they're coming from right from the bottom there, but there's also little shoots just there, and there's some more coming around here. This one is a brain strain 7-pot chili, and then there's another one here, similar sort of thing, but this one I haven't chopped back yet, but I may do. But you can see it's got lots of new growth. And this one is a Trinidad Moruga scorpion. Thought I'd show you my grow box. To like a, I think that was a cat litter tray covered in foil and a couple of 30 watt 6500 Kelvin bulbs. And inside I've got some plants. I've put them into separate trays just so I don't get mixed up. I'll try and show you how bright it is. I'm only going to put 2 potatoes into the Sarpo Mira. Right, what I'm using is bog standard compost again. Here's my bucket. I suppose that's about a third compost. I'm going to take roughly half a cup of my mix. Just put it into the bucket and mix it up. Here, 15th of the 4th, 2016. Right, plant now our pulled beans now. Just grab one there. Nice roots. Place our plant in them. Just thought I'd show you my grape. It's really growing now. Even got some little bunches of grapes on there. There's grapes everywhere actually. Look at that. Oh, even up on the top. God, I'll have to cut some of them off. Here's an update on the sweet corn I'm chitting. You can see some going there now. I've already taken some out actually. What I'm doing is I'm putting it into these. Can't remember what they're called.
I'll put it up on there when I finish. They don't like their roots being disturbed, so it's better to have them some, you know, deepish pots. Right, where have you got these cable ties, these red cable ties? I've already done all them. Pick up a sweet corn that's sprouted. A little sprout on it. And drop them in the hole. Just going to get a bit of water. Water on it. And that's it. I'll just water, give these a bit more water. The reason we do the sweet corn like that is because you know you're going to have 100% germination. You know you're going to have the whole tray filled up with plants ready to go out in the block. Hello. Welcome to Plot to Plates. I'm Plot. I thought I'd just do a little talk about water timers and watering system. Right, this is an old one that I've had for ages. I use these on
off of water butts.
Now the main thing with when using them on water butts, you have to have a zero head. So what does a zero head mean? It means that there's no restriction through a timer. There you go, it's got a hole right the way through. One of my shortest videos maybe. So, happy gardening, stay in touch, like and subscribe if you want to. Cheerio. Right, today I'm planting my gutter peas. First off, I'm going to give the gutters a good watering. This makes it easier to remove from the gutters. I'm just going to water them in a bit as well. Well, we've got the frame around now. Took the fleece off of the broad beans. I think they're probably hardened up enough now. Anyway, kettle's on. Time for coffee. Well, the kettle's boiling. I'll just do a quick update. These are my carrot bins. See the carrots all coming up. That one is Autumn King. The other one is Sweet Candle, and I come down to my onions. Well, I'm going to sow some runner beans today. Just going to fill some pots up. Here's the seed. Anyway, I'm going to put them in that way round, sort of a narrow side down. I like to give them a good water, big seeds like this, because they need to rehydrate a bit. Already got the labels made out. Runners, 30th of the 4th. Right, so here we're going to do some cobra. Climbing French beans. That's the same as all the other beans. They're in saved seed again, 2015. Basically, they look like that. Climbing French bean, cobra. Again, give them quite a good soaking to rehydrate the seed. Alright, I'm back. That didn't take long, did it? I think I'll take you on a tour of the polytunnel so you can see how things are going on here. I don't think I've done it for a few weeks. Be right back. Oats. They're marigolds. These are some bunching onions. These are some cauliflower all year round. They're doing brilliantly. Then we got some little gem lettuce and some iceberg lettuce that we just recently put in over here. Kate's just put some, what's she put in? Ah, there's the label there. That would help, wouldn't it? Oh, she's putting some sunflowers. And two lots of tomatoes. Saint Pierre from my own seed. And Marzano from also from my own seed. And we've got a load of brassicas, and broccoli. The onions are still growing, I haven't put them out yet. The other ones from seed. Some more early purple sprouting. And these are the beans I've just been sowing with you. Two trays of cobra, 24 plants, three trays of runner beans, some seeded sweet peas. Charlotte potatoes. These are the other onions, Bedfordshire Champion, grown from seed. And these are some tomatoes. This is a sweet million, my grape. Could almost be called Lingford Christie. The speedy's going. Down here I got my banana shallots, Zebroon. Right, that's it. Not much more to show you. Happy gardening. Tuesday, May the 10th, 2016, and it's been raining. Actually, it's quite refreshing, but you can see I've got some of my potatoes in. Well, actually, I've got all of them in. I've got a few long there, and all the rest are up there in buckets. The apple tree is looking great. The birds are still in the nest around the corner. Just going to pop some of these peppers. This one's California Wonder. This one is called Beauty Bell, or Beauty Bell. Again, looks very good. These are grown under my grow box, in my grow box and my grow light. Just ordinary bog standard compost from a well-known supermarket. I'm just going to add a bit of feed, slow release fertilizer. Mix it up. I've also got a bit of perlite in here, as you can see. These have been potted up before. See the roots on there? Lovely set of roots. I'll sort of measure it in the pot first to see how much soil I need to put in the bottom. Pop it in the bottom. You can also then see where the height's going to be as well again. And then just fill the whole pot up. Tap it down a bit. Pull the pot out. Take your pot. Pop it in the hole. Tap back around. Job done. Put the label back. Beauty Bell. Right, that's the peppers done. And I've also taken a leaf from Nigel's idea, Muddy Boots, using insulation tape. Thank you, Nigel, for the tip. Can you hear the rain? Just a quick update on the climbing beans. I think these ones here are the cobra. I think that's the two there at the back. And the runner beans. Alright, I'm just gonna pot up a couple of tomatoes. This is one is called Saint Pierre. Saint Pierre. Oh god, I've got no holes in my bucket. Buckets with no holes in. It's called ring culture. So when you plant them into the soil, you water around the outside and feed on the inside. If you have a look at this, I've taken some of the bottom leaves off and I'm going to plant right up to there, right up to the first set of leaves there. Then all roots that grow down from this stem and fill this pot up. If you have a look closely at the bottom there, see all those little hairs? Well, they're roots, or potential roots anyway. Take this pot out. Oh, left one behind. And another one. There you go. And drop him in the hole. Sink him down low. And fill in around the edge there. That's our little gem lettuce. My onions need to go out. Anyway, you might have already guessed, I've put my spuds out. These are the sarpineras. Oh, it's 10 buckets, sorry. 5 in each row.
I planted out 2 rows of beetroot.
Anyway, that's it for another day. It's still the 10th of May. It's bye from me, I think. Happy gardening. And let's hope we get sun comes out again and we don't have rain for the next 6 weeks. Putting our sweet corn out after that lovely little bit of rain. I'll show you what this Somerset level stuff is like. I think it's composted from the reeds that grow in the peat beds down in Somerset. It's pretty good stuff. What we're also trying to do is to plant them a little bit deeper than they are in the pots. I believe that the roots grow out the stems anyway, and it'll also give them a bit of support. And just water them in. Already done quite a few. Just show you my tobacco matter buckets. Look, full of slug slime. All of them. All of them got slug slime in them. Can you see the apple tree behind me? It's coming out into blossom. He's been picking sweet peas again. Well, that's it for another day. We've worked quite hard, me and plate. Just about to go home. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave any questions, answers. You know the score. Okay, we've been sowing some onions today. Well, I'm not sowing, planting them out. Two rows are just done. Temperature champion. I'll just finish going for the bed. That's pickling shots. I've topped up my potato buckets. I got these rhubarb that my cousin grew from seed. I'm gonna replant them out, I think, by the maybe between the mint and the horseradish. Just want to keep them separate so that I know which ones is which. I'm not sure what is a rhubarb. These are copra French beans, climbing French beans. Just put them out to harden off a bit today. These are runner beans. This is autumn fruiting raspberries. And these are the summer fruiting ones. Over here is plates blueberries. This is the apple blossom I showed you yesterday. See if I can get a bit more of a close up of it. Oh, there you go. Well, that's it for today. We've worked hard again today. Not done a lot, to be honest with you, but I suppose when you get our age, it becomes hard work. See you again soon. Lovely evening here at the moment. Camera's parked behind my shed, looking out towards a tree and over fields. Hope to see you again soon. Happy gardening. Putting our beans out, and then we've got cobra beans in that next one. And then some more cobra over that side. Peas are really going well. More beans. Lots of flowers on the strawberries. Where's that? I can't see the camera now. Oh, there you go. I can see. You also put the runner beans out. That white stuff is lime. Not sure if it works, but the idea is to keep the slugs away. Sweet Williams from last year. They're starting to flower now. Still haven't cut the comfrey down. The apple tree blossom's starting to fall off now. Sweet peas and the polytunnel are still growing. Nice smear perfume. I wish you had a smelly vision. I've potted up my overwintering fillies, the super hots. I try not to overwater them. I keep them on the drier side. This is the bell peppers. Really nice plants now. Is Femme spot.
Oh, that's a femme spot as well there.
Over there is a pumpkin, munchkin pumpkin as well. And then behind that is an early butternut squash. A grape, still growing well. And chilies in here. Those are those plug plants I have.
They're cauliflowers all year round.
Beetroot, doing really well. Thought I'd show you my global bucket.
There you are. That's what I've been doing. A walking brassica cage.
Well, I hope you found that interesting. Happy gardening. See you soon. Just a bit of that fake little bucket. I think I mentioned you have to punch down in the middle so you form a wick in the centre. But I didn't mention you have to keep giving it lots of water as you go along, filling it up. Punch it down again. Leaving the sides more fluffy. Need to make a bit more soil up. About 20% perlite. Right, the other update with this, I only put half a cup of the dolomite lime in last time, but I think it actually needs a cup. I looked it up after the video, sorry about that. So you just mix a cup of dolomite lime into the 3 to 6 inches of the top. That's for magnesium and calcium deficiencies. And also on the slow release fertilizer, I'm also putting a cup around. So it's an equal amount of dolomite lime and fertilizer. And just keep that, just cover that up like before. And that's it now, we've just got to plant the plant. This is the way I do it. Got some comfrey leaves, stems, I've got a few flowers in there. I don't think it really matters. But anyway, cut it up a bit small. Get yourself a big bit of wood and smash it well. Get your pulverized comfrey. Bucket. And I get some rainwater and I fill the bucket up. This will get topped up again later, just keep topping it up. What I've decided to do is put it on top of my water butts. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to place a couple of bricks on top. Just to give it a bit of weight, weigh it down. And that's about it really. Where my comfrey bin. Sweet peas are still going. Well, that's another day. I don't know if you can see the bird behind me. You can definitely hear him, can't you? All the little chicks. Cheer out. Just preparing the bed to put some out in. Just digging a big hole. Flood the holes out. I'll let that drain. Finished off digging me holes and flooding them with water. Put the tomatoes in on the weekend, I think. These are the pots. Mop cut out. Put the pot in. Here's the tomatoes I'm doing. And the maker. Right. I'm going to try and get the pot out now. There you go. Leaving the hole. There we go. Money maker. A bit of water on the outside, a little bit on the inside. Right, that's them both in. And there's a string going up. Right, let's put the tomatoes in. Just recap on what I got. The first two here are Sweet Million. The next two are Saint Pierre. One is from my own seed over there. Just doing a comparison, and this one's out of a packet. The next two are San Marzano, which are like a plum tomato for cooking. And the last one is the two money makers you've just seen me putting in. I've got a puddle. No, it's not rained. Just watered the path down. Help take the temperature down a little bit. Increase the humidity, which stops red spider mite. Right, we're going to plant out some butternut squash. Dug a big hole. You didn't want to see me digging the hole, did you? I'm going to just get a good flood in the water before we start. On the soil I dug out, I'm going to put some chicken pellet and a bit of fish blood in there. Right, I'm just going to put some manure in here. It's well rotted horse manure. And Bank Holiday Monday. Right, now I'm going to bring the topsoil back over here. Make a mound. Just going to pat it down a little bit. Before Clate plants it. Right, Clate's planting the butternut squash. See the little one? So the right of me is one of the most important tools on the allotment. A chair. Second to the cattle. Sweet peas have gone. Sorry about the strimmer. I've put up a water barrel near my potatoes. As you can see, I've connected a hose to it. I've only got one barrel at the moment. I might put another one out tomorrow. And then the hose runs down through the barrel handles. And I've drilled some holes in the bows. And I've put a bit of blue pipe over the where I drilled the hole because it's actually squirting out. I'll show you. You should be able to see it. See that? If I put a bit of blue pipe over and then it's going to just dribble into the bucket. Runner beans are starting to move up the sticks. The birds have flown the nest. This video was shot over a number of days. And normally mine are done in one day. Bye. There's the grape. It hasn't actually grown much more, about 18 inches maybe. And this is the cucumber. We've got tomatoes. We've actually got tomatoes coming on there, if I can get in to see them. This is sweet peppers in the global buckets. This is the overwinter chilies, and they've grown fantastically. Some grapes that were self-seeded. This is the bunch of onions. And this is the beetroot. We look quite like the beetroot young, so actually I think we'll be pulling some of them pretty soon. And look at this rose. Look at that. Oh, good job to lift that up. Courgettes, common name. These are the butternut squash, the early butternut squash. Showed you me putting them out. There's actually one coming there. And there's another squash over there. I think that's a munchkin pumpkin. Down there. This is the Charlotte potatoes, the early ones. Might be taking one of them up in a minute, maybe in this video. First reveal. We need some for dinner. Look through the net on the cabbage. Well, they've been eating some of them, but there's plenty for us, I think. And that's the kale. Some nice cabbages in there. I think we're having one of them for tea. Then we come to the runner beans. I think they were... Oh, there's a load of black fly down there. Get the spray on before there's too many flowers. And this is the Sarpomeras. They're really tall now. The Sarpomera flowers. And we come to the Sweet Williams. Look at that, full of flower now. They were planted over a year ago and they're a biennial, so we left them in. This is a sweet corn. bit of squash in between. Showed you me that's planting them out. We got the peas. Her screen shaft. They've grown quite a bit since my last video. These are the broad beans. Pods are filling up. This is the strawberries. I got no trouble finding red ones this time. Let's take this off a bit. There's a nice big one over there. This is the contained bin. I'll take a bit of this and just squeeze it between your hands. Oh, I love that smell. If there's some potatoes in that bucket, I think we'll have some of that with it. New potatoes and mint and butter. And that's the horseradish. That's also an invasive plant, as you can see. It's escaping around there. These are the radish parsnip rows that I can see down here. There's actually parsnip. And there's a few more up there. And that was seed saved from the plot next door. So I think the secret with parsnips is fresh seed. And then there's some more beetroot outside the polytunnel. They're not going to be so big, are they? Well, no, they're not as big, but they're coming. These are the seeded onions. They're not looking too bad. And these are the pickling shallots. That's bunching onions. These are the sweet candle carrots. Have a quick look inside there. Don't think any would be big enough to eat or anything. No, not yet. These are the autumn king carrots. This is the apple tree that I was pruning back earlier in the year. It's put on quite a lot of growth. That must be 18 inches of growth there. Is there any apples? That's the question. There was some before. There's some apples. Some more up there. Some more hiding in there. More sweet peas that we sowed growing up the wigwam there. These are the summer raspberries, as you can see. We've actually got raspberries. I think Plate's just picked one in at it. I might do the same myself in a minute. And these are the autumn fruit and raspberries. Oh, we've got flowers come in there. Obviously no fruit yet, being autumn raspberries, but they're a good size now, aren't they? Look at that. I did have a video of me clearing them out when there was virtually nothing there. So that's it for now. Happy gardening, and I'll see you later. Cheerio.